हम लोग देखा जाए क्या रूल है नॉन होमोजीनियस इक्वेशंस को सॉल्व करने के लिए बाय मैट्रिक्स मेथड। सी रूल केस वन, रो ए इज लेस देन रो ए बी, मीन्स ए की रैंक ए बी के रैंक से कम हो जाएगी, यानी कि ऑगमेंटेड मैट्रिक्स का रैंक ज्यादा है रैंक ऑफ ए। देन द सिस्टम ऑफ इक्वेशंस ए एक्स इज इक्वल टू बी आर said to be inconsistent, it means they have no solution. When the rank of A and rank of AB both are not equal, in that case the system of equation AX is equal to B will have no solution. Come to case 2, rho A is equal to rho AB, it is equal to small r, then AX is equal to B is consistent. Matlab agar dono ka rank same hoga, to AX is equal to B ka ek solution hoga, it means we say that it is consistent. केस टू में ए आ जाइए आर लेस देन एम, तो एन इनफाइनाइट नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस विल एग्जिस्ट। इफ आर इज इक्वल टू एन देयर विल बी अ यूनिक सॉल्यूशन, इफ आर लेस देन एन देयर विल बी एन इनफाइनाइट नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस। इफ आर लेस देन और इक्वल टू एम लेस देन एन देन एन इनफाइनाइट नंबर ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस प्रोवाइडेड रो ए इज इक्वल टू रो ए बी। इसका मतलब हुआ कि सॉल्यूशन विल एग्जिस्ट ओनली व्हेन रैंक ऑफ बोथ द मैट्रिसेस ए एंड ऑगमेंटेड मैट्रिक्स ए बी दे आर इक्वल। Here m is your number of rows and n is your number of columns. Let us see one example. Show that the system of equations 2x plus 6y plus 11 equal to 0, 6x plus 20y minus 6z plus 3 equal to 0, and 6y minus 18z plus 1 equal to 0 are not consistent. See here, the given system of equations is non-homogeneous because we have terms 11, 3 and 1 in these three equations. So this is non-homogeneous system. See its solution. Given AX is equal to, the matrix A will be matrix made up of coefficients. So the coefficients of X, Y, Z are 2, 6, 0. Here in the second equation, 6, 20 minus 6. And in the third equation, 0, 6 minus 18, X, Y, Z. And this is equal to minus 11, minus 3, minus 1. See, this is your plus 11. So if you substitute it to right hand side of equality, it will be minus 11. Similarly, minus 3, minus 1. This is your B. So AB means augmented matrix will be 260, 620, minus 6, 0, 6, minus 18. And dotted line, minus 11, minus 3, minus 1. Now it will be equivalent to, you need to make here 0. Here it is 0 already. So R2 will change to R2 minus 3R1. So it is equal to, it equivalent to 260 minus 11, and this is 6 minus 2 into 3 means it is 0, 20 minus 3 into 6 means it is 2, and minus 6 minus 3 into 0 means minus 6, and minus 3 into minus 11, this is your 30. And the third row 0, 6 minus 18 minus 1, no change. Next, we will make R2 goes to 1 by 2 R2. Divide this row 2 by 2. So this is equivalent to 260 minus 11, 0, 1, minus 3, and this is your 15. And the third row by 6. So R3 goes to 1 by 6, R3. It means 0, 1, minus 3, minus 1 by 6. So it is equivalent to 260 minus 11, 0, 1, minus 3, 15. And it is 0, 0, minus 91 by 16 after R3 goes to R3 minus R2. So subtract this R2 from R3, then you will get this one. See here, this is your matrix A, reduced matrix A, this is your reduced matrix AB. From this reduced matrix A, the number of non-zero rows is 2, therefore rank of A is 2. But from this reduced AB, reduced matrix AB, the number of non-zero rows is 3. So rank of AB is 3. It means rank of A is not equal to rank of AB, therefore the given system of non-homogeneous equations is not consistent. It means it is inconsistent, so it will have no solution. See, so this, we also made R3 goes to minus 6 by 91 R3, so it is 1 here. So here rho A is equal to 2, but rho of AB is equal to 3, means rho A is less than rho AB, therefore the given system of equations is inconsistent. It means it will have no solution. Next, come to another example. Solve x plus y plus z equal to 6. x plus 2y plus 3z is equal to 14, x plus 4y plus 7z equal to 30 by matrix method. You can see this is also an example of non-homogeneous equations. So because here you have 6, 14, 30, they are not zero. So it is non-homogeneous. Now evaluate the augmented matrix. The augmented matrix will be AB. It can be written as take the coefficients of x, y, z. So it is 1, 1, 1 in the first equation, 1, 2, 3 in the second equation, and 1, 4, 7 in the third equation. And these are right hand side numbers 6, 14, and 30. So it will be reduced to, we will make here 0 and here 0 by R2 goes to R2 minus R1 and R3 goes to R3 minus R1. So 1, 1, 1, 6, and it is 1 minus 1 is 0, 2 minus 1 is 1, 3 minus 1 is 2, 14 minus 6 is 8, and here 1 minus 1 is 0, 4 minus 1 is 3, 7 minus 1 is 6, 30 minus 6 is 24. So this is your reduced matrix. Again, we can reduce it by dividing the third row by 3. So R3 goes to 1 by 3 R3. So it is 1, 1, 1, 6, 0, 1, 2, 8, and 0, 1, 2, 8. Because 3, if you divide the third row by 3, then it will be 0, 1, 2, 8. Now you can again reduce it. So it will be 1, 1, 1, 6, 0, 1, 2, 8, and here 0, 0, 0, 0. Means we have taken R3 goes to R3 minus R2. So this third row the second row is subtracted from third row. So third row becomes 0, 0, 0, 0. Now you can see the matrix A is reduced to this form, which is an echelon form, and it has two non-zero rows. So rank of A is 2. Also the matrix AB, this matrix AB, it has two non-zero rows. The third row is 0. So rank of this matrix is also 2. It means both matrices have the same rank 2. It means the system of equations is consistent. So they will have some solution. See, rho A is equal to 2 and rho AB is equal to 2. It implies that rho A is equal to rho AB is equal to 2. Thus, the system of equations is consistent. That is, they have solution. Also, since rho of A is less than 3, see, rho of A is less than 3 means number of variables. Therefore, there will be an infinite number of solutions. So the reduced system is written as 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 2, 0, 0, 0. See, this is our A, reduced matrix A. This is x, y, z, and this is 6, 8, 0, the right-hand side elements, numbers. So if you expand this one, you will get x plus y plus z equal to 6, y plus 2z equal to 8, and only y plus 2z is equal to 8. The third row is 0, 0, 0, so no need to write here. So you take just the value of z equal to lambda. So in that case, y will be from this equation 8 minus 2 lambda, and x will be from this equation 6 plus 2 lambda minus 8 minus lambda means lambda minus 2. So x will be lambda minus 2, 8 minus 2 lambda and lambda. So this is your solution of this equation. But since here lambda is arbitrary, you can take various values of lambda, and for those various values of lambda, the given system of non-homogeneous equations will have infinite number of solutions. Why? Because rank of A and rank of AB, both of them are equal, but they are less than number of variables 3. So you will have an infinite number of solutions. After this, there is an example for you. See the example. Solve the system of equations x plus y plus z equal to 9, 2x plus 5y plus 7z is equal to 52, and 2x plus y minus z is equal to 0 by matrix method. This is a problem for you to practice. That is why I have written here in the solution part, do yourself. So this problem will be solved by yourself. You solve this problem, and if you face any difficulty, you can give me a message. After this, we will go to your next topic, eigenvalues and eigenvectors. First, we will discuss what are these eigenvalues and eigenvectors. And after that, we will have an example, and after that you will have some problem to your practice. Till now, this is all over for today class. If you have any query or any questions, you just send me a message on my WhatsApp number or on my email. Also, this lecture will be uploaded on YouTube. So there is, you can also view the lecture from YouTube. There is a comment section in YouTube. You just send your comments in the comment section. From there also, I will reply your queries or clear your doubts. So till then, you just note down all of them, and you need to make its practice and make a note copy after, because I will be demanding your note copy, and you will get marks for that note copy.